Rodgers and the Carolina Panthers. The first game's out of the way. Time to buckle down for the long season ahead. And we're off in week two. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Here's Newton. And they get to Newton and take him down for the sack. Leonard Floyd, the old Georgia Bulldog, finding his way into the backfield.
This offensive line has struggled. In fact, when we sat down with the coach, he said it's been in tatters lately. They allowed 6 sacks in their last game. Just gave up another one right there.
And tatter, so it sounds a little bit like this right now.
Exactly. It's like that paper being ripped. And right now, they've got to find a way to get it back together.
So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. To throw is Newton. Here as he's taken down. That sack by Khalil Mack.
It always helps for a visiting. team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. And he'll try and hurry the kick, gets it away, but it's not looking that great. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And it'll be a short field for the Bears as they take over first and 10. So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's the first carry for Tariq Cohen. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Championships. All my records go hard. It's a champion hit. Yeah. I've been working for this moment like I've been in the gym. Jumping all over hurdles, I'm evading the pit. Yeah. Hit the hit with anybody, take them, I can shake them. Yeah. I invite them to the fire, then I bake them. I'ma break them. I'm a Hall of Fame legend. They should go and hang my jersey. Yeah. Made to put in work. I don't think they really heard me like. Yeah. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. Yeah. Ain't no stopping me, ain't no topping me. I am up. Number one seed. Nobody popping up. Got a squad of gorillas from the jungle suited up. Yeah. You kicking off against me. Hope you ready. Get it up. Yeah. I be booted up. Popping out a sprinter or a truck. Whole team chasing bags while they chasing us. Calling all the. You get hit if I miss. Then my teammates got the blitz. Yeah. Move the chains. I'm about to make a play. Move the chains. Tell them get about the way. Move the chains. I'm about to win the game. Move the chains. Baby, tell them move the chains.
Yeah. I do this for the family. So for real, who feeling that glowing hill? I'm giving a soldier chills. My jewelry coat is chill. Stories treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah, Ripper stuff the edge like I don't know no feel. See the pain deep in my eyes, they know it's real. Yeah, been this way, way before the deal. Say this one for your photo real.
All right, Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Chicago Bears and the Carolina Panthers. The first game's out of the way. Time to buckle down for the long season ahead. And we're off in week two. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
Security.
First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. He takes this for 3 to the 29.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments and doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. They get the first. The decision to run on third and medium winds up being a good one.
First down. First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a toss. This is McCaffrey. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Akeem Hicks that time on the tackle.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Third and 11. And some extra depth to the secondary here. They're on the dime. Out of the gun, Newton. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. They are in a zone. Remember, folks, 4 interceptions for this defense a week ago. First drive, make it number 5.
And the focal point will be the people who pick the ball out of the air. But let's not forget, to make that happen, it has to be an excellent pass rush, terrific coverage where they are plastered to the receivers, and then, of course, taking it away, making the catch, and going in the other direction.
The first carry for the shifty Tariq Cohen. 20! A huge play there for Chicago. 41 yards. Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. Here's Trubisky to the end zone, but it's incomplete. Evan Engram was the intended target, but it'll be second and goal.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
They'll try again here from the 7 on second and goal. They'll run on second down with Cohen at a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed.
A big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's third and goal. On third down, a run with Cohen, and they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to bring up a fourth and goal. Looking at this situation, if you're at the 1, the 2, maybe you go for it. From here, you kick it.
I agree. I think you have to get points in this situation. Fourth down, I don't chance it at all. I put the points on the board and go back and regroup.
had just the one big play on the drive, but that was enough to put him in field goal range.
Yeah, one big play of what they hope will be many others throughout the game. Every team has a different target for the number of plays like that, those explosives that we talk about. That allowed him to put points on the board on that drive. Let's see how the rest of the game goes.
After the field goal, here's Tavecchio to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive.
Set the tone, defense. Let's go.
The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey, and he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
To throw on 2nd and 6. Newton, that's going to be caught by Samuel. He's at the 40. The 20. Touchdown, Carolina. Curtis Samuel, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Graham Gano on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point,
the kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
Call it a 3-yard gain, and it's a 2nd down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
To throw again on 2nd down, Trubisky. This one into the hands of Burton. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Now they face a 2nd and long following the holding penalty. Now it's Trubisky. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Now Trubisky on 3rd and long. And Ingram hauls it in. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. A gain of 22.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end. A guy that you can line up anywhere. In the slot, out wide, in tight. Doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's 2nd and 2. On 2nd down,
It's Cohen, and only able to get two here, stopped at the 30. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Watch the slant. Watch the slant. Motion. Motion. 57's the mic. Watch 57.
They'll try to run for it with Cohen. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. First down for the Bears, a gain of 15. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. The Bears with the football. We get set to begin quarter number two as they've got it with a first and 10. They'll complete this to Ingram as tight end. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll make this a 2nd and 13. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And this is incomplete. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. But now it's 3rd down.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete.
Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29, Vernon Butler drops him for a loss of 10, and it's going to be 4th and long. Tavecchio puts this one through, and they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you 6?
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Well, they had to run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Now, meanwhile, here's a 2nd down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the one he was looking for. And it's 3rd down.
And a set. 180. 48 right now. Let's go.
I got you, boy. I got you, boy.
Newton now to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Gilchrist.
Well, this is simply a great read by a defensive back. It's 3rd and 10, so he sits right on where the yard to gain marker is, knows it's going to be a route around that distance, makes his read, breaks on the football, and makes a terrific play.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. First down, a run with Cohen. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. A Chicago first down there on a gain of 11. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
18 yards there, and it'll be a 1st and goal. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Tariq Cohen, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Bears have retaken the lead.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had 2 previous drives that ended in field goals. before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
Yeah, it worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Tavecchio. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Newton. And his throw here is incomplete. He was trying to get that one into the hands of Christian McCaffrey. Third down here.
Certainly looked like maybe his third or his fourth read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet, man, that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Throwing on third down, Newton. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Here comes Cohen. Just a 25-yard punt. Not what he was hoping for by any stretch. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. On first and 10, it's Trubisky. Flushed out right. Finds his tight end, Ingram. A good pickup there, a 22.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. That'll bring up second down. Trubisky gives to Cohen. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 11 yards there, first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
First down, here's White, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Touchdown, Chicago. Evan Ingram, his second touchdown on the season as the Bears push further out in front. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder coming up at halftime. We'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in his second week of the regular season. And nowhere for him to go again. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Patrick Onwuasor up to make the tackle.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Two runs for a net gain of nothing. Now here's third and 10. Now Newton. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him to have two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
And the drive starts with a completion left side. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Mike, 54, let's go. 54 is Mike. Check, watch 54.
Five.
Now Trubisky to throw. He's got Burton here. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Trey Burton. His third touchdown now on the year as the Bears push further out in front. Heck of a start to his season. He had 2 touchdowns in the opener last week, another one here in week 2.
Well, I don't want to call him a touchdown machine this early, but sometimes you get locked in, you know, and you feel good about things. You get into that zone, and those touchdowns come in bunches. He may be off to that kind of a start.
It's like he was shot out of a cannon. I would imagine success this early, great momentum going forward for the rest of the year.
He keeps this up, they'll soon be chanting MVP anytime he touches the ball.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, look at the clock here. You're inside of a minute. First half hasn't gone that well for you. How are you going to play this drive?
Well, I've been told by my coaches previously that the intelligent approach, go ahead and run out the clock and start over. Don't make any more mistakes. But there's also something to understanding that you've got this last drive here. You get the ball to start the second half. Try and go 2-for-1 here. Get some points now and come out of the locker room and get more points again and get your momentum really built up.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll just keep 2 hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a 3rd and about 4 for a first. Back to throw, Newton. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
It's now fourth down.
Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks.
You ain't going nowhere.
A final shot before the break. Newton. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And look at this. Cam Newton intercepted a 3rd time. Eddie Jackson picks it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick.
Let's go,
first down. At their own 39-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Here's a handoff to Cohen running right. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. And just like that, it's third down. From the gun, it's Trubisky. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. Well, third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five.
Hey, 18.
Check 15. Check 15.
Move.
They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. Open man right side is Ingram. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. They were caught in no man's land that time, but the decision to go for it, that was the right one. It's a first down.
Watch the pass.
Now Trubisky on first down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
Here's a good way to kick off a drive, complete over the middle, and able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. It's a Carolina first down on a gain of 16. Now they can breathe a little easier, some room to operate, as they've got it first and 10 now out past the 20. They'll run with McCaffrey. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. There to make the tackle, Khalil Mack.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
To throw on second and six. Newton looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Curtis Samuel, the intended target, and it's third down.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Now it's Newton. Escaping, and a big loss here as he's taken down. Khalil Mack tracks him down away in the backfield for a loss of 16. Here's Michael Pilardi now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Oh, it's a wobbler here. Now a fair catch called for and taken here, and that'll set up his guys in great field position. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He finds Robinson. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Trubisky now 10 of 16 throwing the football. It's first and 10. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Again, it's Cohen. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation. They come out here in the eye. On third down, Cohen. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Tariq Cohen. His second touchdown of the afternoon as the Bears push further out in front. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Tavecchio. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Eddie Jackson picks it, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard. And they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Throwing here, Trubisky. And now nothing but green ahead of him. The 40. Past the 20. 10. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick 6. Panther touchdown.
Now that was a beautiful play. A pick 6. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
You mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
Extra point was hooking, but he does make it through. And that'll cut the lead back down to 21. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This will be taken short. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. Your 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in 2-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call 4-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Quick throw here caught by Gabriel. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. On second down now, it's Cohen. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of 1 yard, and they're going to face a 3rd down. And some room to work. 20. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. And he is finally going to be brought down, but not before he gets it to the Panthers 13. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Down to the 6 yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker, and you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air, because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
The Bears on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be 3rd and 6.
Hey, 18.
57. Looking to throw again, Trubisky. And he's got his man. That's Robinson. Touchdown, Bears. Three touchdown passes now for Mitchell Trubisky as the Bears push further out in front. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
This will be taken very short. And not a great return here. He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he goes down. It's a sack. They get him back at his own 3-yard line. Khalil Mack picks up his 2nd sack of the afternoon. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 16. From his goal line here, Newton. He's going to look deep now for Landry. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Jarvis Landry, the intended receiver, and that'll make it 3rd down.
Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well-coordinated. The front and the back really in sync.
And he can't get away. Newton can't escape the pressure, and it's a safety. Things are just going from bad to worse now. It's a safety that does him in here, and that is one frustrated offensive unit.
They can't get out from under their own shadow right now. I mean, I know this is the NFL, but could you imagine a college crowd right now? Imagine what they'd be doing. They'd be chanting, start the bus, because they think this one is over.
We play to win. Let's go.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
He's got a 1st down and then some inside the 40. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. A big play there on the option. 48 yards on the ground. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's 1st and goal just outside the 5. Here's Trubisky. And that is caught
But the back judge right there to say incomplete.
The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
The second down attempt there, knocked down as it leaves the cornerback's hand, and it's incomplete. A big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's third and goal. And he is caught at the 7-yard line. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack?
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
This fielded at the 2.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you've got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
To throw on 2nd and 6, Newton. And they get to Newton and take him down for the sack. Khalil Mack able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his 3rd sack of the afternoon. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing 3rd and long. From the gun, here's Newton. Going deep here for Landry. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 25. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. Landry, the intended target. Gosh, you add up last week and this week now. That's 9 interceptions in this 2-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost as if they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, partner, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe he'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
Well, they've said they believe in him. That's being tested right here.
16 yards is the pickup there and a 1st down for Chicago. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some 1st downs, just as good as running the football.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Trubisky now to throw on 3rd down. This is White on the screen. Good contain, no gain on the screen, and it'll bring up 4th down. So unable to get any yardage at all off of the screen there on 3rd down.
And ordinarily on 3rd down, that's when you want to bring pressure. You get all your guys who want to get after the quarterback. But how about the patience they showed? Read the play, snuffed it out, and made a nice stop.
And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got it 1st and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Looking like they're well on their way to a 2-0 start. All smiles right now on that sideline, isn't it?
As well there should be. It's hard to win a game in the NFL. We hear it all the time. We know that it's difficult. But guess who's smiling, but inside is thinking 24-hour rule because we're going to have to play again next week.
Boss man.
Oh, without a doubt. The head coach, he wants them to feel good, but at the same time, find a way to keep improving.
This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They are just obviously getting shellacked here on this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it because
you're not going to want that feeling
no,
again.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
Throwing on second down. Newton. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he will score. Touchdown, Chicago. The lefty Tavecchio now to add the extra point. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This one fielded at the 5. And a good effort on the return there. Gets them across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 47. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. With that interception, he just set a record that nobody ever wants to set, and that's the most picks ever in an NFL game. Eight.
The last time we saw 7, 2001, right?
Yeah.
He's with the Lions at that time. To get to 8, are we sure he knows what color jerseys his team's wearing in this one?
I don't know. It has not been good. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. Oh, Trubisky going to throw. And that'll be incomplete. He was looking for Evan Engram, the tight end. And it's 3rd down.
After that throw, and it was definitely one that he would love to have back, I wonder what's going through his head. I wonder what kind of mind game he's playing with himself to get himself back on track. Because a lot of guys, that's what they do. They have little triggers that when the mechanics are off, or if they make a bad throw, that they go to that place to get themselves back in sync.
His big game continues. 10 catches now, and another first down.
Alert! 57's Mike.
On first down, Trubisky. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with this one. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Tavecchio.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
A big offensive explosion help leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Bears, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they'll drop to 0-2. And they'll be off to Oakland next week for a date with the Raiders. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.